Most of us, at least in my generation, were told the fable of the tortoise and the hare. We see the very slow tortoise and the very fast rabbits right there at the starting gate. And when the gun sounds and they're off, all of us thought, the first time we heard the story, that it would be the hare, the rabbit, who would win. As it gun sounded and off goes the rabbit, leaving nothing but a vapor trail as it fast disappears over the horizon. Left behind is the very slow tortoise, putting one foot in front of the other. No one gave any thought that the tortoise would win. Well, the fast rabbit became overconfident and cocky and decided to stop and have lunch and visit with friends, and time got away from him. But the tortoise kept doing what he was doing, putting one foot in front of the other. So we learned out of that fable that the race does not belong necessarily to the fast, the quickest, the smartest, the prettiest. It belongs to the one who is slow and steady. I'm amazed how we are reminded of the importance of little things. This morning in my devotions, I even read that passage from Zechariah in which the children of Israel were going to build the temple. And at this point, all they had done is got out the plumb line, got out everything to make sure it was square and where it was supposed to be, and kind of outlined where it would be. A very, very small step. There was no temple. They were only getting prepared to do it. And God says to them, do not despise the day of small things. And yet I think we live in a world in which small things are constantly despised. Now, I'm not saying that you and things and make a big difference and do giant kinds of things, but slow and steady and small. Someone, I read a writer this week who said, if we do what God wants us to do in the natural, he'll provide the super and we'll make it supernatural. I noticed that the first Monday of the new year, when I went to the YMCA where I exercise, you couldn't get on a machine. You couldn't hardly get into the building, even in a pandemic, because everybody had made New Year's resolution enough that I understand that if you just wait till Valentine's Day, when they all eat their first 10-pound box of candy, they'll all fall off the wagon. Here's what I know the Bible says. If you have faith the size of a grain of mustard seed, big things can be accomplished. Don't despise the small things. As a matter of fact, we are told continually in Scripture, if you want to have bigger things, be faithful in the small things. Oftentimes I've heard people say, you know, if I had a lot of money, I'd give toward that. Oh, if I were retired or independently wealthy, I'd volunteer and help. And here's what I have to ask you. Is that really true? If you're not being faithful with the little bit that you have right now, whether it's your resources, there is nothing magical or mystical about some out there in the future time when everything is going to line up for you. Here's what I know will make a difference. Find out what it is you really need to be doing. Find out what it is that God wants you to do and start taking baby steps and small actions to move yourself that way. You've already proven in your life that it can be done. I'm assuming that everyone looking at this video has already brushed their teeth today. You were not born knowing how to brush your teeth. You had to learn it. And now it has become such an easy habit in your life that you don't even... You want to read the Bible? Get up early tomorrow morning. Open your Bible. Read for 2 to 5 minutes. Start developing the habit. And once you begin to exercise that muscle, you'll begin to do it more and more. Part of my morning routine is not only Bible reading, but other kinds of reading and journaling and praying and exercise and working on some most important tasks. One of the things you're going to have to do if you want to accomplish a few little things is to get up a little earlier. The problem with most of us when we understand there are big changes that need to take place in our lives, we create these huge ideas of what we need to do to change that totally disrupt our lives, and within 2 or 3 days, we've fallen back into the status quo and the old habits. I'd say find one thing you really want God to help you work on and try it. Make some incremental changes. It is Small changes done daily, consistently over time with the lever of time, that have a compound influence in our lives. There's an old song we used to sing back in the old days, "Little is much when God is in it." All you and I have to do today is to offer God the little that we have and allow Him to take the rest and create whatever He'd want to do. I want to stop by telling you an exercise I've been doing for the last 2 or 3 years, nearly every night and most every morning. I was going through a pretty difficult spell a couple of years ago, and a particular passage of scripture that has been so meaningful to me has now become the way I bookend my day. I start the day with it, I meditate on it, I recite it to myself, to the Lord, and I end my evening, the last verse. It's in Philippians chapter 4 when Paul was in prison. So he was going through a tough time. And here's what he said: "Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice." Now, Paul was pretty specific. He didn't say rejoice when you have money in the bank, when you have a lot of friends, when everything's going your way. Rejoice in the Lord always. Always is an inclusive and exclusive word. It means there are no exceptions. Even when I'm going through a hard time, I start my day by saying rejoice in the Lord. Not in my circumstance, not in my problems, not in the victories. I'm going to rejoice in the Lord, and I'm going to do it morning and the evening. Let your gentleness be evident to all. And so I remind the Lord, help me, Jesus, today, regardless of what happens, to have a gentle answer and to respond. Let my gentleness be evident to all. What is evident to people about you when they spend time with you? I'm probably not by nature nor disposition a gentle person. Therefore, I need to remind myself at the beginning and the end of the day, Jesus, please keep me gentle. And then the other thing it says, the Lord is near. Always remember, whatever you're going through, is Jesus is here with us. He's not off somewhere. He's right here. Now, here's the part that really helps me as well. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, make your requests known to God. Don't be anxious about anything. Anything is, again, an inclusive and exclusive word. It literally, in the Greek, means anything. Any problem, any circumstance, any situation, regardless. I need to take my anxiety and give it to the Lord and pray to Him about everything. And so I start and end my day by saying, Lord, all the things in my life that are causing me anxiety, I turn them over to You, and I ask You to take care of them. But in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving. You know, we just don't go to prayer just to be going to prayer with petitions, but thankfully that we have a Father who listens and who cares and is interested. And let your requests be known to God. Anything that's on my heart, I give it to the Lord. And then this wonderful promise to both start and finish your day. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your heart, which is the entirety of your life, and your mind in Christ Jesus. When I pray this scriptural prayer, I ask God, You come with a knowledge that it cannot be learned or understood, and You can bring peace to my heart and life regardless of what I'm going through, and You can give me peace in my mind. Jesus, be the guard of our lives and our hearts today. May I pray with you, Father, I thank You for my friends. And today, may I go, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice, regardless of what's happening today, Lord. We have much to rejoice. Let our gentleness be evident to all we have conversations and interact with on this day. And we're not going to be anxious about anything, Father, but in everything, through prayer and petition, we're going to make our requests known to You. And the peace, Your peace, will guard our hearts and bless us, Father, we pray. Help my friends today in wonderful ways. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen. God bless you. Have a great and wonderful day, my friends.